wait for long for others. So very good afternoon to all, or if you wish to wish you a good evening, I'm ready to wish you good evening also. So children, let us begin our session today. We discussed active and passive voice imperatives, the two different formulas in the previous session using you are requested, you are told, plus another formula we used is using let. Okay, I hope that these two formulas are very clear for you guys, right?
Yes, ma'am.
You are able to change one sentence in imperative into passive voice using any of these two formulas, right?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. So I'm going to introduce a new topic, which is not new, but it is a part of active and passive voice. But the kind of sentence is different. We completed declarative sentences in the form of all the 12 tense forms. We have completed imperative sentences, and we have learned two formulas also. And today we are going to learn how to transform an interrogative sentence and interrogative sentence from active voice to passive voice. It is not simple. Like imperative, it is not simple. You need good sense to convert or to transform one sentence from active voice interrogative to passive voice interrogative. And this is the last topic under active and passive voice. Okay. So listen carefully. You need to learn the same topic when you come in the seventh standard also. The same topic is there. Active and passive voice is there. How to change an imperative into active and passive voice there. How to change an interrogative sentence from active voice to passive voice is there. So please be very careful. Okay? So children, listen. Mm-hmm. What are called interrogative sentences? What are called interrogative sentences? Can anyone define an interrogative sentence?
Ma'am, interrogative sentences are question.
Excellent. Exactly. You're right, children. Children, interrogative sentences ask questions. Okay? It is in the form of, or it is used to ask questions. Okay. It and you know, an interrogative sentences are ending with a question mark, and this punctuation mark is very important if it is a question. Okay. Without a question mark, a question is not at all a question. Remember this. And my dear children, listen, we are going to learn there is no particular rule to apply for converting one sentence from active voice into passive voice. Okay. There is no rule, but we need to learn for a few points before changing an interrogative sentence into a passive form. Okay, ready?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. As you all know, an interrogative sentences are of two types, right? There are WH
questions.
You are familiar with WH question because all these sentences are starting with WH words in English. Okay, these sentences are starting with WH words in English grammar. Okay, and the person who is asking using WH question is expecting a particular answer, or that person is collecting information through asking questions. Okay, and normally a WH question is starting with WH words in English grammar. And you know, you are familiar with yes or no questions, okay? Yes or no questions, where the person who is asking a question is expecting an answer, either yes or no from the listener, right?
Yes, ma'am. Yes.
Can you come with me? Yes, ma'am, I can. Are you coming with me? Yes, ma'am, I am coming. Okay, so see, I actually want to ask you a few questions, right? So these are called interrogative questions, two types, WH questions and yes or no questions. At the same time, when you change an active voice interrogative sentence into passive voice, in the passive voice also, it is in the form of a question. It is not a statement. There also it is in the form of a question. So remember to put a question mark at the end in a passive interrogative also. You must use the punctuation mark called question mark in active voice and also in passive voice. If you change an interrogative sentence from active voice to passive voice, remember to put a question mark in the passive voice also. Okay? This is point number one to remember. Okay? Am I clear?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, fine. And point number two, if your question in active voice starting with the do, does, did. The so-called do forms. Remember? Another point that you should remember always, you should note down, is if a sentence, if a question, when a question, if it is starting with the do, doesn't it, it is not possible for us to use the same do, doesn't it in passive form. Okay, we cannot use do, does, and did in passive voice. If your active voice question is starting with do, does, or did, then if we cannot use do, does, or did in passive voice, so which form should be used there in passive? Can you guess? You know, do, does, or did does not appear. Okay, do, does, or did does not appear in passive form. If it is not appearing in passive form, if your active voice question is starting with do, does, or did, how can you begin your sentence in passive? Gus. I'm giving you the freedom to think.
Ami, sir.
Yes. Who said this answer?
Ma'am.
Very good. Devika and Gidika. No, nice. Ma'am. Rhyming. Gidika and Devika. Rhyming. Okay, both the cars, greats. Okay, it's not the car in the Jungle Book, it's the car in 6A classroom, right? Okay, so Gidika and Devika, excellent. We should begin.
Ma'am,
yes, Devika.
Ma'am, only Devika said the answer.
You did not say. I saw yellow border. I mean, I thought you are also said the answer. Very, very, very good. Very honest. She said, ma'am, I haven't. Only Devika said, excellent. Okay, very good. I appreciate that. Excellent, child. Very good. Wonderful. Okay. Thanks. So listen carefully. If the question is starting in active voice or starting with the do forms like do, does, or did, it does not appear in the passive form. Instead of that, according to the tenses, according to the subject, you can use am, is, are, was, were, there. Okay, if your sentence is starting with the do or does, if the subject is singular, you can use am, is, are. Sorry, is. If the subject is plural and it is in present tense, then you can use are. At the same time, if it is did, if your question is starting with the did in active voice, when you pass or when you transform this did into passive voice, you can begin your sentence. If the subject is singular, you can begin with was. If the subject is plural, you can begin your passive voice interrogative sentence with where. Am I clear? Am I clear, children?
Yes, ma'am.
So, do, does, or did does not appear in passive voice. Than that, we can transform that active voice sentence into passive voice beginning with am, is, are, according to the tenses. Okay? According to the tenses, according to the subject. If the subject is singular, use a singular verb. If the subject is plural, you can use a plural verb.
Excuse me, 1 minute,
Smriti. I can see many videos are off here. I request everybody to turn on your video. Please do ask your question. Smriti?
Yes, ma'am. Did you take any new portions now?
I'm starting with the interrogative, active, and passive voice, my dear. As you joined later, you may be feeling a little difficult to follow. Just the beginning. I'm just introducing interrogative sentences to you. How to change an interrogative sentence from active voice to passive voice. Point number one, just a recap. Though for those who join later, so just a recap. Okay, listen carefully. Point number one that we said is, if your sentence is in the form of a question, okay, if your active voice sentence is in the form of a question, remember a question is ending with a question mark. The same question mark should be used in the passive form. Clear? Point number two, I said, if your sentence is beginning with the do forms like do, does, or did, it does not appear. The forms do, does, or did does not appear there in the passive form. Instead of do, does, and did, we can use am, is, are, was, were, according to the tenses and according to the subject. Okay? If the subject is singular, you can begin your sentence with the singular, am, is, and was. And if the subject is plural, you can use are or were according to the tenses. Okay, ma'am. This is what we discussed until now.
Yes, ma'am.
Now point number two. Okay, as I have told you and you are familiar that a the interrogative sentences are of two types, WH questions and yes or no questions. Really, you are clear? Okay, so if your sentence in an active voice interrogative sentence is beginning with WH words or has, have, had, which call the have forms in English grammar, or it is starting with the modal auxiliaries. What are the modal auxiliaries? Can, could, will, would, shall, should, all this, all these are called modal auxiliaries. Okay, if your active voice sentence is starting with the WH words or have forms, or if it is starting with a modal auxiliary, you can use the same question word like WH words, or if it is in the form of have or has or had, or if it is a modal auxiliary, the same words you can use it in passive voice to begin your sentence. Okay. So there is only one correction. If your sentence is actually starting with do, does or did, you cannot use the same question word there in the passive form. Than that, you should begin your sentence with am, is, are, was, where, if your question in active voice is actually beginning with do, does or did. Clear? Question number, point number two, I said, if your sentence is starting with, if your interrogative sentence is starting with have forms, like has, have, had, or if it is starting with the modal auxiliaries, can, will, would, shall, all such things, okay? And if your sentence is starting with, interrogative sentence is starting with the WH words, you can begin your passive voice sentence with the same. There is no need for changing it, okay? There is no change in the passive voice. The beginning of the sentence should be the same. Clear?
Okay, ma'am.
Okay. Now, point number three to remember. Okay? Point number three to remember. Okay? If your interrogative sentence in active voice, if it is starting with the who? Repeat. Let me repeat the sentence. If your interrogative sentence in active voice is starting with who? When you transform this interrogative sentence into passive voice, listen, you should begin your passive voice sentence with by whom. Okay? If your question in active voice, interrogative active voice, is starting with the question word who, WH word, but still it is who. This is an exceptional case. Okay? If it is starting with who, WHO. When you transform this interrogative sentence into passive voice, remember, you can begin or you can use by whom in your passive voice sentence. Clear? Am I clear?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. So, if your active voice interrogative sentence is starting with who? W-H-O-M. Whom? Okay? Whom? So, how to begin your passive voice sentence? Why is he was a reverse order? You should begin your passive voice sentence with
who.
Okay? Who?
Let me
repeat the same point. Listen, if your interrogative active voice sentence is starting with the who, WH word, but still it is who, WHO. You should, when you transform this sentence into passive voice, use or you begin your sentence with by whom. Clear?
Yes, ma'am.
So who
yes,
ma'am. Is changed into by whom in passive voice. Clear? Okay. Yes, so again, if your sentence is starting with the who, it should be changed into passive voice, or you should begin your passive voice sentence with who. Clear? Whom yes, into yes, who. Yes, am ma'am. I clear?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, so let me discuss one more time. Let me give you a clear cut idea. Interrogative sentences. I have told you interrogative sentences are questions. Okay, we ask questions and such questions are called interrogative sentence. You know, police officers are coming for some interrogation, right? They come and they ask, they prepare a list of questions, and with the question they are coming to us and they may ask a lot of questions. What is your name? At this time, where were you at this time? Or they have, who is working here? Who brought this? Or such questions they were having, and they will be coming with the same questions and they'll be asking us. Okay, as these questions are of two types, I have told you there are two types of interrogative sentences, right? There are questions like in the form of WH questions and yes or no questions. Remember, WH questions are always starting with WH words. Okay? When, where, which, how, and all. But there is an exception, who. Who is playing some other magical power here? Okay? So remove who from that list. Okay? Except who, all other WH words. And here, using WH words, we are collecting information from others. Isn't it?
Yes, isn't ma'am.
We are collecting particular information from others. At the same time, the second type of questions are called yes or no questions, where the person who is asking a question is expecting either yes or no from the listener. Right? So, yes or no question. Normally, an yes or no question is starting with auxiliary words. Okay, normally we do start our yes or no questions using auxiliary verbs. It can be be forms, it can be do forms, it can be have forms, or it can be a modal auxiliary verb. Right? Agree?
Yes, ma'am.
Agree?
Okay. Yes, ma'am.
And listen, a few points to be noted. Point number one, if your active voice sentence is in the form of a question, after transforming the sentence into passive voice, remember to put the punctuation mark, question mark at the end of passive voice sentence. Point number one is clear?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay.
Point number two. Listen, point number two. The auxiliary verbs like do, does, or did does not appear in passive voice. Let me repeat. The auxiliary verbs like do, does, or did does not appear in passive form. Instead of do, does, or did, if it is used in active voice sentence, when you transform these active voice sentence into passive voice, instead of do, does, and did, you can use the words am, is, are, was, were, according to the tenses, according to the subject. Clear?
Yes,
that point is clear?
Yes, ma'am.
Fine.
Yes,
ma'am. Fine. Very good. Very good. Very good. Now, listen, your point number three. I'm going to give you point number three now. Point number three is, we have another auxiliary verbs called have forms. We have WH words in English grammar. We have modal auxiliaries in English grammar. Okay. So if you see your active voice sentences are starting with any of those forms, like have forms, has, have, had form, WH words, or if it is starting with the modal auxiliaries, remember you can use the same words to begin your passive voice sentence. If it is has, have, had in the question word, if it is WH words like what, where, when, and all in your question word, or if you are using a modal auxiliary in your active voice, the same question words can be, or same auxiliary verbs can be used in the passive voice form. There is no change. You can begin your passive voice sentence with the same words. Clear?
Yes, ma'am.
And the last point, small exception. That is an exceptional case in English grammar. If your active voice sentence is starting with the word who, W-H-O, who, okay? After transforming it into passive voice, you should begin your passive voice sentence with by whom. So, who is changed into by whom? By whom? By whom? Okay? And if your sentence in active voice is starting with whom, you can use who in your passive voice. Clear?
Yes, ma'am.
Clear?
Yes.
All those points are clear for you guys?
Yes, ma'am.
Let me show you a screenshot. Not screenshot. I'm going to share a screen for you based on this interrogative. Just look at here. Passive voice interrogatives. I request everybody to note all these points. Children, do, does, or did does not appear. This is very important. It does not appear in passive voice form. Okay, the words like do, does, or did. Okay, another has, have, had, according to the subject. What do you mean by according to the subject? If the subject is singular, you should begin with has. If the subject is plural, you can begin with have. If the question is starting with have, And if the subject is, because object becomes the subject in passive voice, right? If your object in the active voice is a singular subject, you should have to use has only, right? To begin a question. Sir. Yes. So according to the subject, it should be has, have, and if it is past tense, you can use had.
Excuse me, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Ma'am,
Ananya.
I can't understand the third point, ma'am.
Ma'am, can you show the board?
No. Ananya, ma'am. What did you ask?
Ma'am, I didn't understand the third point.
Third point. I'm coming to the third point. Okay. So first point, is first point clear for you, Ananya? Ananya?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. What about second point? Has, have, had? Clear? Ananya?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. So remember, has, have, had, have forms according to the subject and modal auxiliaries like can, may, will, shall and all, must, may and all. Okay. If it is question words like when, where, why, how, what. Except who, okay? Except who, if your active voice sentence is beginning with any of these words, you can use the same words. There is no need to change anything. There is no need to change. It is beginning or from the beginning position or it is the same in the beginning position. We don't want to change, okay? But as Ananya said, she needs more explanation for point number 3. Okay, if your sentence is starting with who, okay, I'll give you examples, then that will be clear for you. Okay, our sentences, if your active voice sentence is starting with the letter or the word who, you need to change the sentence into its passive form. Okay, when you convert a sentence with who or starting with who from active voice to passive voice, you begin your passive voice with by whom. Okay, who is changed into by whom in passive voice form. At the same time, if your active voice sentence is whom, starting with whom the word, you must use your passive voice sentence or you should begin your passive voice sentence with who. I'll give you examples. Okay, then it will be clear for you. These are the 3 points that you should remember. There is no particular rule to use. These are the points to remember. Okay, ma'am, there is no, see, we had learned imperatives, there are 2 rules to be applied when you change one imperative sentence into passive voice. We had learned it, but at the same time, here for interrogative, there is no such rules. Okay, only few points that you should remember. So I'm going to introduce a few questions for you. Ready?
Can you show the board?
Sure. I'll adjust the slide.
Thank you, ma'am.
Okay, children, please copy down fast. If you're writing, you do it fast. Then I can show you some examples. And these examples will give you a clear-cut idea how to change an interrogative active voice sentence into passive voice. What are the things to be remembered? Noted. I'll send you all this in the school's website. Okay, don't worry. Don't spend too much time on the slides and all, because I'll be uploading everything in the school's website. At the same time, I'll pass this to your class group also. Okay, so let me give you a few examples. See, children, examples for interrogative sentence. Okay, here's a small error. It is not she, it is you. Okay. See, did she recognize you? The question is, did she recognize you? It is a question word, okay? You can see it is starting with the letter did, the auxiliary verb. It is a yes or no question. And we have a subject here. We have a verb here. We have an object here. And did recognize is the verb used here. Right? So we got the subject, we got the verb, we got the object. Okay? And this is an interrogative sentence because it is ending with a question mark and starting with the auxiliary verb. Okay? Okay? So we are going to change the sentence, this interrogative sentence into passive form. Remember the 3 points. When you change an active voice into passive voice, the object of the sentence becomes the subject and subject goes in the place of object. Agree? Yes, agree. Yes, ma'am. So you is your subject here, isn't it?
Yes, ma'am. Yes.
And did recognize yes. shows that the sentence is in which tense form? Did recognize? Simple?
Simple past.
Simple past. Did. Did past tense. Did recognize shows that the sentence is in simple past tense. Okay. So we got the subject and object and verb of the sentence. Now we are going to change this interrogative sentence into passive voice. Okay. So this sentence is starting with the did. What we said a few minutes before. We cannot begin a passive voice sentence with do, does, or did. Okay. If we cannot begin our sentence with do, does, or did, how can we begin our sentence?
We
must use, instead of do, does, or did, we must use am, is, are, was, where. As the subject is you, I should begin my sentence with, and the sentence is in past tense. I have two options. I can begin either with was, or I can begin it with where. As the subject is you, which one is correct?
Where.
Because I can use where only with you, right? So my sentence, I should begin like this. My passive voice sentences, where you, yes. Okay? Where you, and past participle form of the verb recognize is?
Recognized.
Okay? Recognized by, and the subject her. Becomes the object, her. Her. Okay? And yes. I should remember, or I should always put a question mark at the end of a passive voice interrogative. Clear? So, did she recognize you is changed into where you recognized by her. Something is clear, but not fully, right?
Yes, ma'am.
Not fully, right?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, don't worry. Look at the question number 2. As Ananya, be very, very alert here. Question number 2. Who wrote this book? Okay. Who wrote this book? So here, the hero is the word who, isn't it?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Because we had learned, or a few minutes before, we have learned that who, when you change this interrogative sentence into passive voice, who is changed into by whom?
By whom?
Okay. So if the sentence is starting with who, if my interrogative sentence is starting with who, so I should begin my passive voice sentence with by whom. Okay. By whom? Yes. And you know, the subject of the sentence is this book, because this is the object of the active voice. Okay. Who wrote this book? So here the object is this book. Okay. So this book is singular. So I should use an auxiliary verb was after by whom. Okay. By whom was this book? Past participle form of the verb write is written. Okay. By whom was this book written? If it is these books, instead of was, you should use where. Why was? Because the sentence is in simple past. The verb is in the simple past form. Am I clear?
Yes, ma'am.
Am I clear?
Yes, ma'am.
Ananya, are you clear now? Ananya?
Yes, ma'am.
Clear now?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. So let me share the third example for you. See if your sentence is starting with the has, have, or had. We can use the same word to begin your passive voice. But remember, when you change a sentence into passive voice, you should, the verb is always depending upon the subject, right? If the subject is singular, use a singular verb. That is why, see, you is the subject, have finished is the verb, the work is the object here, isn't it? Isn't it?
Ma'am.
Yes or no?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes.
So which word is right here?
Has.
Has, because the work is singular in use. Okay. So has the work. This is in have finished shows that the sentence is in present perfect. Okay. Present perfect tense. Clear? Am I clear? So I should use been here. Right? Right? Am I right?
Yes, ma'am.
I have written a letter. Okay? So how to change the sentence into passive voice? Have written shows that the sentence is in present perfect. Right? So how to change the sentence into its passive voice form? It is in present perfect tense.
A letter is?
It is in present perfect. Still, I'm pointing out this one.
Ma'am, a letter has been.
Written by me. Very good. So, by me. As the sentence is given in present perfect, you have used has been written, right? The same rule should be applied here. Have finished shows that the sentence is in present perfect. So, your sentence should be, or you should begin your sentence with has plus the work plus been plus finished by you. Here, so this is a little complicated one. Interrogatives are a little complicated and you should be always clear about the tenses. Okay? You should always think before changing. Many things to be noted. That is, we cannot use do, doesn't it to begin our sentence. Okay? If your sentence is starting with has, have, had, if the subject is singular, you cannot use have. You should begin your sentence with have. Okay? Okay, and also if it is have finished in the form of a present perfect, been should be used. If it is a present perfect or past perfect tense, Harriet and Xavier, you are chatting between you guys. No. You're not listening. You're laughing and laughing. I don't know what is the reason for getting so happy. Okay, so children, please listen carefully. So this is what I need to explain today. I'll be coming with more examples for the interrogative sentence in the next class. Remember, this time your exam is on December 16th or 16th or 17th. We are starting your exams, MCQ 3 exams. This time, English grammar and English literature separate paper. Both the papers you need to write 20 marks. Okay, English grammar is out of 20, English literature is out of 20, two different papers. Okay, so that means you will be getting more questions from English grammar. I want you to attempt. Okay, let me tell you one more time. Your MCQ 3 exams are very close. We are starting from December 16th or 17th. And you know, you should learn a lot because this time it is two different papers. It is not one single paper. Okay. English grammar is out of 20 and English literature is out of 20. Two different papers. Okay. So you will be getting 20 questions from English grammar and 20 questions from English literature. So you cannot skip grammar. Yes.
Excuse me, ma'am.
Yes.
Ma'am, have you taken declarative sentences?
She wrote a letter. What type of sentence? Or tell me the kind of sentence. She wrote a letter. It has a subject, it has a verb, it has an object in it. What kind?
Declarative.
So you know what are declarative sentences, right? It has 12 tense forms. We can write a declarative sentence using 12 tense forms also, right? With one subject, one predicate, and with one finite verb. Okay? One finite verb means it has the tense, right? So we have learned already the 12 tense forms. How to change out of 12, how to change 8 forms into passive. That is over. So we started with imperative. That was also over. And today we discussed interrogative. I know that this is not sufficient for you today. So I'll be repeating the interrogatives in the next class. Thank you so much coming here and attending the class. Okay. So remember, exams are of two different papers. Grammar 20 questions. So you cannot skip anything. The topic for you is, let me tell you the topics. Kinds of sentences. Four kinds of sentences are there for the exam. Active and passive voice are there for the exam. And types of sentence, simple, complex, compound. Subclause and main clause are there for the examination. Ma'am, thank you so much. Yes,
Ashish.
Ma'am, the notes of active and passive.
I'll send. Okay, don't worry. Now, anyway, I have completed, so I can send you the notes to the class group. Thank you.
Thank you, ma'am.
Very well. I'll explain this topic in the next class also. Okay, with more examples.
Okay, ma'am.
And we'll drill it.
Okay, ma'am.
Thank you.
Thank you, ma'am.
Thank you, ma'am.